Hello. Today is a day that has traditionally been called Holy Saturday. It is the day between Good Friday, when Jesus was crucified, and Easter, when Jesus rises from the grave. So it is on this Saturday, which was the Jewish Sabbath, that we gather now for our devotional. I'd like to read the scripture, which is from John chapter 19, verses 38 to 42. And this is the story of the burial of Jesus. After these things, Joseph of Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus, but secretly for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. And Pilate gave him permission. So he came and took away his body. Nicodemus also, who earlier had come to Jesus by night, came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 75 pounds in weight. So they took the body of Jesus and bound it in linen cloths with the spices, as is the burial custom of the Jews. Now, in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden, a new tomb in which no one had yet been laid. So because of the Jewish day of preparation, since the tomb was close at hand, they laid Jesus there. In all four gospel stories of Jesus, they tell the story of him not only being crucified, but of him being buried. And as I was thinking about this, I realized the importance of the fact that we would have a story of Jesus being buried. For without that, there could be no proof that Jesus actually came back alive. The custom in the days of John's writing was that when a person was crucified, they would be left for the vultures to pick at the body. Now, the Jews wouldn't do this, but they also wouldn't allow family to take the body away. Rather, if a person was crucified for sedition, they would be taken outside the city and buried in a mass grave. Now, if that had happened, there would be no knowledge of where Jesus was buried. There would be no proof, actually, that he had been resurrected from the dead. So as the story unfolds, we have two people, Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus, who follow the nudge of God and bury Jesus in a tomb so that we would have proof, so that we would know where his dead body actually was laid. You know, the importance of Jesus being buried is highlighted not only through the New Testament. For example, when Paul talks about not only Jesus dying but being buried, but it's also highlighted for us in the Apostles' Creed, which is a summation of what we believe. In the Apostles' Creed, as we talk about believing in Jesus Christ, we say that he was born of the Virgin Mary, that he suffered under Pontius Pilate, that he was crucified, died, and was buried. So again, this whole idea of the body of Jesus being taken and laid in a tomb, that we would know where it was, that we would know what had happened, is so important in our faith. Now, as the story is told in Scripture, in John's Gospel here, what is being highlighted for us is not only the fact that Jesus was being buried, but John is highlighting for us these two men, these two disciples, Joseph and Nicodemus. Now, throughout John's Gospel, he highlights individuals and he tells their story. It's almost as if he is inviting us to look at their example of what a life of following Jesus is like. So he specifically, in his gospel, tells us of Philip and Andrew. He tells us of Peter and of Mary and of Martha. He tells us about the man who was born blind and what happened to him. And now, here at the end of the gospel, he tells us of Joseph and Nicodemus. Now, Joseph was an unlikely candidate for actually doing what he did. He was a member of the Sanhedrin, and John tells us that he was afraid of what the Jews would think. And yet, when he was nudged by God, he went to Pilate, and he asked Pilate for the body of Christ. He was willing to go secretly when nobody else was willing to go. He was willing to be bold and to be courageous and to carry out this important act so that we would have proof of Jesus' death. Nicodemus, also an unlikely candidate. He had come to Jesus by night in John chapter 3. We read about him in chapter 7 where he makes a little bit of an attempt to defend Jesus. And now here, at the end of the gospel, this unlikely person is now bolder. He goes and he acquires spices, 75 pounds worth. And he and Joseph together take the body and they wrap it in a linen cloth and they layer the spices on Jesus's body and under Jesus's body, and they lay him in a tomb, a garden tomb, where no one had been laid before. These two men rise to the occasion, nudged by God, and by their example, we too have an example of discipleship. In the midst of when nobody else was willing to step up and do this, in the midst of when Jesus' family could not step up and do this, these two men follow the nudge of God. And we have in their example of what a life of service looks like. They were willing to do it alone. They were willing to do this service even though other people wouldn't notice. They were willing to risk, to be bold, and to be courageous, to follow the nudge of God. What an amazing example for us that is given in the life of these two men. When we are nudged by God to serve, and when we are challenged to take a risk, when we are challenged to step out when other people might think differently about it, or when nobody else is willing to serve. What it means to follow Jesus is to be willing to serve and to obey when God nudges us. During this season of coronavirus, this is an amazing opportunity to pay attention to the nudges of God. When someone is brought to our minds, to pray for them. When someone comes into our thoughts, to give them a call. When we get that crazy idea of how we might serve another family, what we might do for them, to obey when we get that thought or that nudge. I want to encourage you on this Holy Saturday to pay attention to the nudges of God, to give thanks for how God allows us to serve Him even in the midst of quarantine, even in the midst of coronavirus. And let us also give thanks for the example of Joseph and of Nicodemus of what a life of faith might look like for us. I look forward to worshiping with you, together yet separate, tomorrow on Easter Sunday.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost. lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear. Amazing grace.